It's Shamise 1982. Just want to let you know I'm just waking up. And yeah, so you can see I'm just waking up. But I am going to take out my flexi rods and going to show you just kind of how they come out. I do two twists in the flexi rods, and just to kind of not use as many flexi rods basically, because it's hard to sleep with them. And my allergies are really bad this morning, so if you hear me sniffling, I do apologize. It's just because my allergies are really bad. But you can see that they come out and they're really, really tight curls. And we're going to actually loosen those up here in a little bit because I have some new hair to show you guys. And so I wanted to do the flexirod curls, just kind of show you how I blend them in and all that jazz. So I, again, apologize for all the sniffling. This morning, it's my allergies are just really bad in the morning, and I apologize for no makeup as well. Don't be scaring me.
Okay, good morning, guys. So I'm just gonna clean your comb through these a little bit to loosen them up a little bit. Normally, what I would do actually is put them behind my ear to hold them. I'm sorry, my allergies are really bad this morning. Put them behind my ear. And that would loosen them up a little bit. And I wanted to show you this new piece that I got. It's similar to the Samara Girl that I wore in the last video. And so I thought I would do a kind of a review and a tutorial on this piece, since it's kind of have a similar curl pattern. And I'm going to show you how I use the flexi rods basically to help blend and, you know, prevent myself from using heat on my hair. And this is her. This one is called Mint Slice. I don't know where they go with it. Mint Slice. I don't know. But this is she. And then just like Smart Girl, you can wear her as a half wig or put her on as a ponytail. And this one's the same thing where you can use heat up to 200 degrees. I don't know why you would on this, but it's possible. You could do it. And this one's by Model Model, and this is one of their cocktail wigs. So, and you can see that it is similar to Samara Girl. This is the curl pattern. She's probably maybe a little bit longer and more layered than Samara Girl. But I'm going to finger comb her out. And you can see on this one that the strands are the little curls again. The little individual spirals. Well, not spirals, but I don't know, waves. I don't really know what you want to call them. But towards the bottom, it starts to get more curly. If you can see that. So that is why with mine, on each flexi rod, I put two of these individual twists on there to help it blend a little better. So you can see it's just very soft, not too shiny at all. Actually, it's kind of like the shine that you would want at when you put oil or any kind of product on your hair. So you can see my hair versus this. I think I got her in a 2, so I got her a little bit lighter than I did Samara Girl. So let me get the tag off. And we'll put her on. You can see, look how it looks on. And I just have my hair in a bun in the back. So, put her on and position her. This cap is a little bit tighter as far as wear goes, but of course it has that drawstring in the back. So for those of you like me who have a big old head, you can loosen it, which I'm going to do right now. Okay, so then I'm just gonna finger comb my hair a little bit to blend it in with the unit. And these curls actually end up being a little bit tighter than they usually are, which I'm not really sure why. Because I didn't do anything different. So. So I'll have to loosen them up a little bit more. But you can see that's starting to go in with the hair. And then I just want to position it. And that's basically what I do. I finger comb my hair into the hair so it can blend in very well. And then try to get the ones that like to stick up and say, "What's up? I'm here to party." Yeah, I have hair that does that. I did the alfalfa. They do the alfalfa thing. Of course, you want to start at the bottom of your curl to do that. So. And that is it. So you can see that this one's a little bit different as far as the length. And she is more layered than Samara Girl. But the curl pattern is pretty much the same. This is a really pretty unit for like the summer or something. I don't know if I'm going to put it up today. Cool thing about this, once you get the curl pattern right with your curls, you know, you can do whatever you want with it. So, I generally wear it down. I'm a bang girl. I like the 90s bangs, big wave bangs. I'm a 90s girl. I grew up in the 90s, so, you know, so. But this is very soft and... I want to say I spent $21 on her. I will put the link below when I purchased it. I purchased it, I believe, on Thursday, and I got it on Saturday. So it's a company that is in Illinois, and I am in Illinois, so I get them pretty quick. I don't know, I like her. So this is Mint Slice. And very simple way that I get the curl. It's all about actually matching the curl to the unit. And you know, you don't have to leave this much hair out as much as I did. Yesterday I had Samara Girl out and I only had this much hair. And then since she's layered, you can push the hair up and in front to create a bigger bang in the front. Or, you know, of course you could put her back. So. And I like to be able to play with my hair because when I have my own hair down, I do the same thing. So I like to different positions. And when I curled it, you know, I twisted it up. And then, and I forgot to film that part. I apologize. And then I put the Shea Butter Grow Strong Strengthening Treatment in with each individual piece of hair that I twisted up just to kind of get that shine to match what the hair, you know, when you first get it, it's got that luster to it. So that's what I put in, and then put the flexirod, and I did put some castor oil on my scalp. I used this Jamaican castor oil just to help with the spots I have here that are thinning. So, and actually I'm seeing a difference already. So I just use a brush to put that on my scalp so I know it's placing correctly, and then massage it in, and that's it. That's all I did. So this is Mint Slice. Of course, there's a comb up top, and then the drawstring and the comb in the back to keep her secure. And like I said, for those of you like me that have a big old head, the drawstring does come in handy because she was initially very tight when I put her on, and I was able to loosen her up with the drawstring in the back. So, I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Hope it didn't scare you with my face. No makeup on this morning. But I wanted to get this in for you guys and let you guys see. It's kind of how I do my blending. For those of you that have a little bit length in front. But if those of you that are still in your big chop time and you do use half wigs, it's easily just get a little comb and toothbrush, smooth it out, and then bring the bangs up front. And you're good to go as well. So, hope you enjoy. I will see you guys soon. Have a great day.